New Jersey, number 32, Mark Dardell. At forward, a 6'7" sophomore from Matthews, Mississippi, number 24, Bernal Singleton. From Villanova, at forward, a 6'6" freshman from Bridgewater, New Jersey, number 13, Lance Miller. From LSU, at forward, a 7'8" sophomore from Hopkins, South Carolina, number 53, Stanley Roberts. Senior from Huntington, New York, number 33, Tom Brown. From LSU, a 7'9" freshman from San Antonio, Texas, number 33, Shaquille O'Neal. From Villanova, a 5'11" sophomore from Houston, Texas, number 15, Philip Walker.
I'll tell you this, Rolly's a master at tournament time. He relies a lot on motivation, control, and tempo. And as we've seen today, defense usually prevails, and they do a great job defensively in their system. However, I really feel with the NBA, look that he's going to go to the NBA, Chris Jackson, I think you're going to see him respond in a positive way. I think the big fellas inside are also going to be dominant, and I look for a good basketball game, but I think LSU is going to move on. I think the motivation of possibly playing in the Super Bowl is going to give him that extra lift.
Very quickly now, two conferences with six fouls.
Well, you look at the foul situation, I think that's going to benefit Villanova because Shaquille O'Neal has a history of getting in foul trouble.
Okay, LSU and Villanova still to come right here. We'll tip it off in just a moment. Let's get out to Knoxville.
And we welcome everyone watching the competition over ESPN tonight with the Villanova Wildcats against the LSU Tigers from Thompson Bowling Arena in Knoxville, Tennessee. Working tonight's game, the official here as assigned by the NCAA, Ronald Latikip, Ted Hillary, and John Lombard. And some things to think about as we get started here. This is the 20th NCAA appearance for Villanova. 7-0 first time for running back to Nino. And what I see, this is the 7th straight NCAA draft. In the last 2 years, the first time having this time to be a ball.
Well, that even goes back further with Villanova in that when they used to treat teams, they're actually 9-0 in first games that they have played. So, you know, they played very well, and their players will have good confidence tonight.
Again, the starting for tonight's game for LSU and Villanova. LSU went 22-8 this year. Villanova went 18-14, splitting the big issue.
Look here, I think, for Villanova to look for some gimmick defenses. I know Massimino is really concerned about Chris Jackson, him getting out of the block. I wouldn't be surprised if they would try some boxing one, things of that nature to disrupt his rhythm.
Well, Jackson got his hands on the ball, and this is Moore Williamson.
They're denying the ball, they're in straight lane. Miller is really overplaying, trying to keep him from getting the ball back.
Just went up for the rebound. He got fouled. The foul is on Mark Dardell. There is it on Miller. Let's check.
Well, here we see it inside. They're really trying to deny up in the upper right-hand corner. They're trying to deny Jackson the ball. O'Neal takes the shot. Roberts fouls the foul. Miller over the back.
That's the first time on Miller. The first time in the game.
Ooh.
Well, this time, they fouled on Greg Ritter. 2,000
fouls on the Villanova offense. They're not wasting their time getting control of the basketball game. It'll be interesting because Jackson's not only going to have to work to get the ball, but I'm sure they're thinking in terms of as he does work, tiring enough that he will not be as effective offensively. Lance Miller will be a difficult defensive assignment for Chris Jackson.
Hopefully Pendleton. Pendleton will come back in at the base court. He just had a quick word to first down. Roberts on the outside. Williamson, at the three. Back to shoot the basketball. They became a much better team than they scored in the third quarter. Back the other way. Walker now. To Miller. To the moon. Going to explore every possibility, try to spread the floor. There he shoots. Rolling one of the foul here, but didn't get the call. Well, Wilson was for the ball out of bounds back there right here. It would have been a tough call either way. A lot of contact. They're going to let him play in the low place. And the ball is back in the game. With the pass, Williamson got underneath him, wanting to do with the ball. Here we see the last time down Jackson. There's a leaner underneath strike. Beyond Miller, off the glass. Danny Roberts got up slowly a moment ago. No, he wasn't looking for the ball in the lane.
I think he's got a contact problem. Williamson went underneath, had nothing to do with the ball. Hit Roberts in the face of the basketball, and he popped the contact. As we talked before, the guy fills it up when he plays here, and he not only does it from the standpoint of scoring, but he also finds a way to come up with 8 assists. So, I mean, you know, he can play the game, and as we alluded to at the top of the show, there's been a report out of Baton Rouge and a lot of talk around here that he's thinking about coming in out, so every game could be his last game. He's got an open field. Plays up, good looking touch in the basketball. Oh, yeah. And now, the team on the 13-8 again, accepts the pass and makes it a 7-2 LSU lead. How do you lose track of a guy 7 foot 2-7? I don't know, but they did it there, and they paid the price. Got ahead to a 10-2 lead over Nova. Well, here we see that last lob down. You know, once again, you got two big guys. Strike rotates over toward Roberts. O'Neal is actually alone. Valdez just forgets about him and there's the lob. Well, LSU's been able to get their transition game out, and it's a little bit different than what we know in that they come down and they look for the three-pointer as opposed to taking the ball the whole way to the. LSU is hot in the field. Mo Williamson has 2 3-point shots. He's had only 3 3-point shots in the last 5 years. There's a lot of room and shutting inside with Bryce and O'Neal. There's Bryce and a foul. LSU foul on Mo Williamson. LSU's looked better defensively tonight on the floor than they have been in the last few games. Roberts is coming out, applying some pressure. They're just letting Bryce and O'Neal go in there one-on-one. They're giving O'Neal a lot of help. They think
they're going to do is they're going to bring it down, and once again, they're trying to get the perimeter guys out. Jackson Lewis Williamson is deadly, taking the ball in the open court, not necessarily in the basket, but just putting pressure on your defense by shooting the ball so well from 3 points. This is a two-point shot to Tom Walker Wooder. Here we go. It's going to be a lob.
Not a very good judgment by Williamson. He got it in 2 feet to the basket, and then they had no place to lob it out of bounds.
Aaron Bain is in now, number 44 for Villanova. They sail down. His 18th year with LSU. A 339 and 201 record. He's 13 and 10 in NCAA games.
They're coming off screens. Villanova's coming off screens. Oak Carroll's and jump shots. They just haven't been able to knock them down. But they still have to identify the inside game and see if they can't get the ball into Bryce.
Another shot to Wooder. Wooder.
This is a bad ball.
Now he's on the line to Stanley Roberts. Roberts is 9.7 rebounds a game.
Well, the thing that Villanova is going to, you know, discover is that they're going to be better off shooting the ball in the perimeter sooner because of the intimidation factor. I mean, O'Neal is so active inside, a guy that's averaging 4 or 5 blocks a game and just has been phenomenal in rejecting passes in there. So they're going to have to look somewhere else to get scores.
Jackson Fraser at the end of it. There's O'Neal. O'Neal against Brown. Belongs to Villanova. Nice play with the inbound by Greg Wooder.
Good job by Bryce. O'Neal's not a college offensive player. He struggles in there. He's more a defensive and a rebounding type player.
Well, 18 years old. I mean, this is Wooder. He had off the glass, but he got it back. And that's a travel call against Bryce and Villanova.
Here we go. Makes a good move to the basket. O'Neal goes up. Long in the shot, gets it back, and then really the intimidation factor is such he just travels with the basketball. There we see a zone, first change of the evening, 1-2-2. Over the top to get Jackson with the ball.
And Taylor was on front. Number one to Rodney Taylor, a senior from Columbia, South Carolina.
Well, here's a vulnerability really good game of boost. He's missed some games because of an injury. He's coming back in there. He's a big, physical, strong type that can play in there with him.
We're going
to see more and more of this where as Jackson brings the ball up the floor, they're going to run people out and force him to give the basketball up. So as Walker comes back in the game, Davis gives Villanova great direction. Walker's on, Little goes out. Little with the ball. This is fun.
Got counted up, and LSU got the basketball.
Well, he's gotten stuck on 10-2 here, and there really hasn't been a lot offensively happening. There's been some decent shots, but it can't seem to get it in the hole. Here we see the zone again.
Mike Miller has scored the only basket for the Wildcats. 6 points to Williamson, 2 for Jackson, 2 for Shaquille O'Neal. Roberts back out to Williamson.
Here we got Miles, we got a triangle in the run, and we've got Jackson getting manned up.
He just went in there and took it away from people.
Oh. As you can see here, he takes it, dishes it off. Good strong move by Singleton to the basket. Going over looking for the charge. Bryce flat-footed, and O'Neal just comes in and out of extension for the basketball. Now he's on the free throw line.
That's the first foul on Tom Bryce. The team fouls are even now at 3. First team ball out to the free throw formation. Shaquille O'Neal and Rick Kimber turning their 3 points tonight.
So it's so important for big guys to be able to shoot free throws. Put so much pressure on the other team in the low post that they can just knock down free throws. They're looking at double figures every night out.
Gavin Bird is in. Lance Miller goes out. And with the miss. And now it's another goal. Gavin Bird got his hands on the ball after that missed free throw by O'Neal.
The only substituting early, you know, it's going to be a long time to get some first bodies in the lineup.
Shooting 10 players through. It's Taylor. And Taylor was fouled by Roberts. First one by Jamie Roberts, and the 14th foul on LSU. play. He just doesn't move his feet. He gets on the side here. Williamson doesn't step in and get the ball stopped. There he is, bottling him up. Good head fake, good ball fake by Taylor. Foul by Roberts, good call. 17-50 mark. It has been all quiet for Villanova. And that's broken finally by Captain Bryce. That's his first basket. Four NCAA games for Bryce. He's averaging 12 points and 8 rebounds. Villanova trying to create some confusion with teams and defenses. Villanova's now 4-point lead. Great move. Right up over the big guy. No foul there. Good no call. That's the first basket for Singleton. Well, one way you catch the zone is to penetrate. And Singleton two times now has penetrated either first off or gotten the ball on the glass. Put a lot of pressure on the Villanova defense. Walker working the ball on the outside. Tried to get the rebound and lost it down the year. James, a guy that has struggled, he started the first 7 games of the season, he's averaging double figures, and all of a sudden when the league got started, things have dropped off, but he's still a very effective player and a very important player for him.
Bain and Taylor leave. Woodard and Miller, Lance Miller, come back in now to Villanova. And Harold Bujo checks back in for LSU. Roberts will get a rest. They draw a sophomore, very young LSU team. Bill Brown said he was close to the season in the wrong cycle. He said he was carrying a lot of Easter basket instead of a run set. They should have been working hard.
Now, one thing that they're doing that's very interesting right now is they're actually playing man-to-man. They're disguising the zone, and LSU is elected to attack it as a zone, but all it is just to decide they're really in man-to-man. LSU needs to run their main offense.
LSU is a 13-4 lead and 12-25 and counting in the first half. Away out of bounds, Villanova's basketball at the baseline.
And well, didn't get the lap quite high enough. Of course, Bryce didn't do a real good job of holding O'Neal off, but that's easier said than done because O'Neal's an exceptional athlete. Bryce has got him right here. He releases too soon and allows O'Neal to get to the basketball. He's got to hold him off longer.
Nice save by Bowles. Bryce has 4 points. A good time, Clemson. But how different is it in playing tonight against Robertson O'Neal?
Much different. You're talking about a Georgetown guy who are big and strong, but they're really finesse players and shot blockers, as opposed to two guys who are in the 280 range that lean on you all night long, and eventually it just wears on you.
The travel call is big, and he's got a 10-point ball right here. So with the ball going out of bounds, it will be down to Villanova. When we come back, we have a timeout on the court. A score. LSU 13, Villanova 6. Welcome to the end viewers tonight. A 13-6 lead for LSU with 11:52 left in the half. Roberts has 4 rebounds for LSU. LSU has on rebound at Villanova. And the field goal percentage, 50% so far for LSU.
Well, it's gotten Bryson back. They tried to get the ball inside. He scored a couple baskets. That's going to screw up that perimeter game.
Woodard couldn't get the roll and couldn't get the rebound.
Well, he didn't get the rebound from that guy. Not when he gets in his hand.
O'Neal with the rebound. This is Williamson. And that's a 3. He has 4 for his own
battery. And now LSU has not really figured out a way to get Jackson open in the half-court offense, but they've been very effective in transition, setting up and shooting a 3-pointer.
Now the 16 points belong to Mo Williamson. And Williamson is 3-for-3 from 3-point range. Chris Walker breaks some moving back. And an air ball. Taylor passes it back to Walker. That's his way to go. Williamson over to Jackson. He's retreating. And he'll walk. And you know, really have something going there, Bob.
Well, just, you know, Jackson, you have to always be ready to get the ball. He's one of the best there is in the open floor situation. He shoots it so quick that he drives the defense to him. He passes it with no look pass. Really a lot of pressure on you.
Randy Duvall, 34, in for LSU. Tom Bryce comes in.
Duvall's a guy that leads for Illinois. Excuse me, John. Duvall's a guy that can really fill it up once he gets it going. I think he's the best defensive player. On the other hand, Bryce coming back in, as well as Taylor, two good strong inside guys to combat the LSU strength inside.
And Taylor into the front court of Illinois. Woodard from the 3-point line, and back in the lane.
Well, he's a guy that gives him a third ball handler on the perimeter. He can shoot it. He he can guard people. He just gives him out with a lot of great facility.
Turner's on a bad job of getting him back on opportunity. And there's O'Neal.
Oh, man. I tell you, you can't believe it unless you see it, because it's just guys that are that big, that are that active, that agile, can come up with the ball, get in the hole. You know, you can't believe it can happen. They're so athletic.
Carson O'Neal has 5 points. 18-6 on our field. Miller on the drive and a foul.
Yeah, here you see it. And all three, this is the strength we talked about at the top of the show. Villanova has to rebound the ball defensively. That's 1, 2, 3. And he finishes. We talked about it, Villanova. You cannot do that against these guys inside.
The foul was on O'Neal, his first, 5-10 foul, 3 on Villanova. And from what we witnessed in the first two games in the Southeast region, we're supposed to let him play, aren't they?
Well, they started out, I think, trying to get control early and called maybe a couple of picky fouls, but now they're letting him play, and that's generally the history of the NCAA tournament. And that's the way it should be.
Well, they're 74% free throw shooter. Another shot coming in at 3 points. Bigger back in for LSU. Bernal Singleton goes over to the bench to go down.
LSU plays 8 guys, but it's really difficult for them to play with Jackson out of the lineup.
Miller goes 1-for-2 on that trip to the line. 3 points for him tonight. Williams is picked up by Walker. Villanova goes back to a man to man.
They're going to have to make an adjustment. They're running with Jackson and they bring the ball up the floor, trying to get him to give the ball up, and Williamson's just shooting the ball right side. They're going to have to come off somebody else to get him to pick up the dribble.
Williamson's going to average in 11.9 again. He has 12 in the first half, and they have 9:19 left.
What is looking for Bryce, but he's been covered nicely throughout the first half all year.
Roberts came over, O'Neal was right behind him.
Well, what's unbelievable is he finally gets out O'Neal off of him, catches the ball because O'Neal has to help out and guard off. And what do you look like? Right, turn around, you got another 7 foot, one guy shoving it out of bounds. So, I mean, it's a never ending story. And Bryce has got to have some frustration, although he has played well early for him.
He's in for Woodard for Villanova. Walking up to down 21-7 with 9:08. Here in the first half of the match.
This is Walker.
He's got a new three opportunity. Bryce with the rebound. 95 on the end.
Well, you shoot it from three, you're generally going to get long rebounds. And when you get long rebounds, that takes away some of the effectiveness of those guys playing underneath the ball. You see it here. The rebound's high. Rebound's long. Bryce comes up with the loose ball. There's the foul right here. A lot of ball. Big second call.
Now Tom Grice is at the line. He has 4 points and 3 rebounds so far. 5 points from Grice. The 74% free throw shooter.
And here we go again. And Neal goes up an interesting anticipation because that's all ball unless you got him with the body.
5 points for Grice. 21-8. LSU with the lead on the ball.
With the lead, Dale might take a look at Big One Neal out of the game.
So that's really a no-go pass over to Singleton.
They're going to pick up his third.
There's O'Neal. Turner with a rebound inside Roberts. Burn in the front court.
It just couldn't go to Bryce.
O'Neal picks it off and turns it in.
This time he's ready to charge, but misses the shot.
Miller saves it off. It's down in the front court.
Taylor from the free throw line. Blocked by Roberts. Roberts got a hand on that, but right back to Taylor.
And a travel call. Gives the ball to Roberts.
Hey, Roberts, it's a 12-man call down, and it looked like he had a pretty good high-step jump. But he came down on both feet and has the opportunity to go back up. And in any case, the ball is still on the ground. And we have O'Neal out of the game.
Okay, pressure now on LSU. Williamson from the double team.
Jackson Jeffers. Jackson, the All-American, has 4 points. 23-8 LSU.
And still over matched inside. Villanova still over matched inside because DJ is so big and strong.
And that's a hit. Gardell tries to save it. He's out of bounds.
Well, Williamson just played like that. He supplemented and complimented Chris Jackson so well with the 3-point shot. If you want to look like you're playing poorly, shoot 16% from the field. That's what Villanova's doing. They're getting good shots. They're just not getting them down.
A great save by Jackson over on the sideline. And on the ball. LSU has 16 points in all, and they threw it. Still, it's 23-8 LSU. This is obviously a bad result.
He's a very good offensive player, much more polished player than O'Neal. They just have not been able to get him the ball.
Now, Chris Walker for Villanova has shot 40% this season. So far tonight, he's 0 for 5 from the field. Villanova tries to force the ball inside, but we got a foul out of the LSU target.
There you see him sliding around. He's on the high side. Never quite gets there. Comes over the shoulder. Easy call for the official. You see, Rowley's racking his brain on what to do. There's not a lot he can do. He may want to look at a change of pace, maybe throw a little bit of press, something to give his team in a little bit better frame of mind. Up tempo. Try to generate some confidence, some easy baskets, but right now they're really struggling, and as they continue to struggle and shoot, they're falling further and further behind, and this is not a good team to get too far behind because of their dominant team size.
Well, with 6:41 left in the half, Villanova's in the running. And then they'll get a ball. He's 2-for-3 from the line now with 4 points.
And he would have got to shoot that again because Gidra had a lane violation.
Another shot now for Miller. The Big East all rookie first team. Five now for Lance Miller. 25-10 LSU.
1-2-1-1. A little bit different looking at the press.
The LSU players are going away. They need to get back to the ball. They almost left Jackson's game. And it's here for Bob, but Jackson saves it for LSU.
Yep, big draw.
Big draw with the foul.
Here we got a good jump shot on the baseline by Singleton. Villanova does a nice job of checking out. Boudreau comes over. Got Miller going to the line. So Miller is a good looking play. He's so active. He gives him so many things. He has not shot the ball particularly well this year. But, you know, when you watch him shoot, you think that he would be shooting better percentage wise. But he's invaluable to him in some other things that he does. And one of those things we just saw, that's rebounding the basketball.
Williamson is back in now for LSU. There's Miller connected on two free throws a moment ago. What's that point? The guy back right out here. Not a campaign by Mark Gardell to keep the ball in that end for Villanova, but it didn't work out.
1-2-1-1 again.
Yeah, they've got a guy to reverse the ball to. That's the key item. Have somebody to pass the ball back to the other side. Great play by Chris Walker. And Miller gets the layup.
Need to get somebody to throw the middle at the 10-7 line. They've got guys down in the corners. They can't throw the ball that long without it being intercepted. This is Vidra.
That's Miller has it for Villanova and gives it up to Chris Walker.
Now a little bit of a run, something that has been historically beaten with LSU giving up the lead.
This is Dodd-Hell. He's in trouble with Robert.
What is it?
Into Dodd-Hell and for Roberts, that's 2 points in a foul.
Well, what happens? Roberts gets a little bit tired and then as a result becomes a little lazy. Instead of moving his feet, he reaches over. He doesn't have to. He can play in behind. 7 foot, the guy's 6'8". The guy's not going to catch the ball. Dodd-Hell's not going to catch it and shoot it over him. All he has to do is play position defense. But he reaches and grabs and now gets in foul trouble.
Foul behind so far so early. This Villanova team really hasn't had an opportunity to come out a lot of fun in the game. There's Gavell's missed the third, beating Gavell. Saved by Gavell, and out of bounds to Villanova. But just watching this team work out yesterday, Bob, you know, the guys had a lot of smiles on their faces. They're here to have a good time and enjoy the NCAA experience.
Well, you know, they had a good time yesterday, but boy, how quickly that changed. You're not having very much fun right now, and that's the bottom line. You got to have fun winning the game to advance in the tournament. They've got to get it on track. They're down, and they need to make a move here before halftime.
25-12. LSU. Oh,
and a low.
Very athletic move just to keep the ball in play.
Well, that's a...
Chris Walker, the sophomore from Houston, Texas.
They've got to look right now for Woody. Woody's got an 8-point conversion, and he can't do that.
A foul away from the ball. And for Leonard, 3 personal fouls.
Well, he's feeling fighting on the knees here. And he's pushing him through 7.
Elbow
to the head. A little frustration there.
A 1-1 now for Tom Brady. The senior from Huntington, New York.
1-10.
10 comes in and Robert goes out.
Can you believe that guy's 6'7", 6'8"? He's got to be 240. Just one big body after another.
He misses on the front end of the 1-1. He's 1-for-3 now from the free throw line.
The season's been a study most of the year, so I mean, this is not an unfamiliar role for him. We're not talking about an experienced player.
Villanova is 4-for-9 from the free throw line of the first half. Trailing 25-12. Then just in to Johnson. He's still with that 3-point attack. That's Miller.
Is one of those guys that just when you think you have him, all of a sudden he breaks loose. He's a guy that can put points on the board very quickly. Villanova will not have an opportunity to relax on him.
As Josh goes out, Calvin Bird is in. David Miller, number 12, is also in the Villanova lineup. 25-12, LSU. Woodard, the back marker, David Miller.
He pushed back in the back of the head. He picked the basketball. They're letting him play.
Jackson is with David Miller.
Ooh.
And first, Jackson, 2 personal fouls. Only 3 teams are down to Villanova. And since about the 6-minute mark, Villanova is done in the 1-1.
Well, here we see it. Jackson comes in. There, hits him on the arm.
David Miller, he has played in 24 games, that is in 6.5 minutes a game. A stress fracture, the left tibia, and he's out in November of 89.
We had a bunch of those this year. It's just been amazing. They've had 3 or 4 guys that have had stress fractures that have cost some time, and most of them were early on in the year. So it's really kind of an amazing deal how all of a sudden it became contagious.
That was only the 14th free throw shot by David Miller this year. The 15 from the line this season.
The press has really helped. It's created a different tempo for Villanova. LSU has not really had half-court offense nearly as well, nor have they gotten an easy opportunity to transition.
Two-time catch the pass. Now down right. Here's Woody. Oh, ball as he hit the deck. There's Jack Bell. Fingerton folks to go through. It's Villanova's basketball, but did Woody ever hit the deck?
Well, I'll tell you, I think he anticipated contact, and all of a sudden it just kind of separated. He goes in, it looks like there's going to be a charge, and then everybody kind of shies off of it, and he never really gets into anybody, and he's anticipating the charge. There's nothing there, and he ends up on his back.
That doesn't leave very much room for a soft touch on a shot, and he's going to get nailed. That's where the intimidation factor comes in again. That is here. Gavell takes the inbound pass.
Well, they've elected not to front right from the low post with Sims, which means they're going to pick their help side up on the box. But Villanova clears that back side. There's not going to be anything there. Either that or there's going to be a jump shot at the top of the key.
What is guarded by Williamson? Miller drives and gets fouled on the ball. It's a basket.
Good move.
And look
throw back from there.
Well, once again, a fact as far as Villanova's concerned, clear side, let these guys kick the ball a little bit because you no longer have the big guys in intimidating the basket. So the last time pass has been caught by Villanova. There's a timeout. That'll be 25. Villanova, 17. A little bit. Oh!
He's wide open. That's a foul on Chris Walker, his first, and only the 14th foul on Villanova.
Well, Williamson did accept the ball in the 10-second line of the trap area, and when he shot that, he's not making good decisions. Here, for example, got to give the ball right back to Jackson, standing for a wide open 3-pointer.
Rolling Macanino, his 17th year at Villanova, his 19th year as a college head coach.
Good job once again is taken as Jackson to get him to get the ball up.
And a foul on Chris Walker, his second personal for the Wildcats. They say the foul is on Lance Miller, his second foul, so race that from Walker. Walker has one, Miller has two. This is Bain back here. Lance Miller has 12, but Villanova is 19 points.
Joe's back in the game likewise to Villanova.
Oh, man. Here he comes, Jackson up. The ball low. And got him in the bottom. He tried to save it in. And he's out of bounds to LSU.
Well, I think they're saying that he was getting stuck in the line and tried to save it, and he threw the ball down the floor, and it hit out of bounds before it went out.
I think that's him.
That Miller was done.
And then he's back. A 1-1 coming up for Colorado. Pendleton picks up a third personal foul for 3 fouls on Pendleton and Wright.
This is the problem that we talked about. This is the concern Dale Brown has. The lack of direction. And it's understandable. You can be an All-American, but nobody can just announce you and say, hey, you're going to all of a sudden be a leader. You're talking about a sophomore. Usually they're playing with 3 sophomores and 2 freshmen, and you just don't make leaders out of sophomores and freshmen unless it's a very unusual case.
Here's that guy. He's got the ball on the other end. Vidal is 1-2 from the free throw line. Now he gets 5.9 points to game. 2 points for Vidal. The press has really made the difference. Not that it's forced into the turnovers, as it just has forced a lot of players' mistakes and judgment by LSU. Sometimes they haven't even turned it over, but it seems to have been very disruptive to what they're trying to do offensively, even when they do break the press. The Panthers, they come here to the official, and the ball belongs to LSU, and it belongs to Villanova, off LSU.
Well, you just see good hustle there by Chris Walker. You know, he's got to be on the all-rounded team. He plays hard, he's turned around, and he continues to show up and play well. Hit himself 3 days ago, told me yesterday he didn't miss this for the world. He's really playing well for him and getting the direction right now.
Well, if you can turn over, six for Villanova.
Just the press, you just have to step to the ball. Villanova has been stretched. They're doing a much better job than coming out.
Really misses on the shot for 3-10 from the rebound.
That rebound off the water. And Villanova has climbed by the end of this game. They have 2:17 left in the first half.
Getting back into the game against LSU, and a foul against Villanova will give the Wildcats, or will give the ball to the Tigers for the Wildcats to trail a 25-8 with 6:57 left in the half, and now down by 4.
Very poor leadership, no real direction in what they're trying to do. The press, Villanova's 1-2-1-1, has wreaked havoc on LSU, not just in forcing turnovers, but also in disrupting their offense from across the 10-second line. No, Benny Brown is stepping to the ball for 10-second line.
There he is. And he can't get the basket. Then Brown gets the rebound. Vigil throws it. And
credit. He kept the ball alive. He kept with it. There you see it. Not necessarily good judgment here on the lob, but Sims just goes up over Goddell, comes up with the ball with his size and strength, keeps it alive, and finally Goodwill's able to shake it loose for an easy basket and a possible three-point play. The foul is on Villanova, who's Dan Bain is first. Even with that blue, Bob, LSU had the number, you're going to lose the score in the first half. And not only that, but what you don't also have at the other end is that two big guys out, Villanova's been able to run their offense, drive the ball to the basket, the intimidation factor is, and LSU's got a little bit easier for them. They were only shooting 16%. Now they're, of course, shooting with more confidence because they don't have the big guys and they're swatting it away. 6:57 left in the half. LSU have a 17-point lead. Now it's 7, and here comes Williams. Poor judgment of Williams, who's part of the way that the Fed Sims was access to the ball. And he had gone over 10 before the last 2 field goals. Now, Walker's getting a couple of impressions. 5 points. A minute and 19 left for the first half, but LSU up by 9. Walker's watched by Jackson. And Bain for Bryce. Bryce is coming by Google. Well, when they don't have the big guys in, they've elected the front. Here comes Williamson. He should pull up at the free throw line and make a decision there. But he takes the ball in too deep, doesn't get a good shot, sends it to follow. They've elected the front place in the low post without the big guys get help off the back side. He's got traffic, doesn't distribute the ball well, he's got a turnover. And that's what a man for halftime. LSU with the lead of 30-21 on the ball. They'll look to Jackson on the left side as they get the clock down. But Villanova's going to have a chance to get the ball back. Williams out there trying to overplay, deny Jackson the basketball. But he'll get the ball. He's just too quick, too clever for Woody.
Jackson has 4 points. 2 for 5 from the field in the first half.
I mean, that's a mismatch. I mean, you've got to get help inside if Jackson's got back touches because Woody can't overplay and also keeping from going to the basket.
So Villanova will look for the last shot of the first half with 20 seconds left on 32-21.
Jackson will get a three. Jackson will get a three right here. He's taking a shot for the three. Jackson tries to spin in on Woody. Williamson takes the three. And that's the way the first half ends.
In the first half, but you know, that's partly because Villanova runs people out and forces them to give it up, and then won't let him have it back. Good move here by O'Neal. O'Neal, of course, with 2 fouls. Roberts with 3, Singleton with 3. Nobody else in the game really in foul trouble, so we should see a wide open second half.
O'Neal misses on the 3-point play opportunity. He has 7 points tonight, and LSU's lead is 34-22. LSU's biggest lead in the first half was 17.
Wide open. The way LSU plays in zones is that they try to cover with the guards, the 3 perimeter players, which then allows the half post to open up. And all they need to do is hit in high right here. Goddell's wide open in the half post as is Bryce. Bryce for the left. LSU rebounds and that's anything. Well, he shoots the hook and it's really not a hook he's shooting towards the basket. Goddell's got a mismatch inside with Roberts. Out to Singleton.
And Bain in for Villanova. What is goes out?
An interesting matchup defensively because
took it in too deep, narrowed down the area. Then Walker had to defend. He gets a hand in there. Here we see it. If Jackson pulls up, Walker's got to make a decision, but he's taking it a little bit too deep here. And Walker first gets a hand on the ball. And a little another steal. There's James. And he got the ball. Right tackle. As he tried to step into O'Neal. Big call because there was going to be a foul on O'Neal. Rice took the step before the contact. Six field time again for Villanova, but they can't convert after the last. Early in the game, Villanova with some 4-4 pickups. Connecticut leads Boston University, 29-28 at halftime. 17-50 left in this game, and LSU is up 34-23. Very Jackson, they got the matchup straight up, and now have Bryce and Roberts. Roberts can hang on, Jackson tries to save it, the ball belongs to Villanova. What he's trying to do is he's trying to come down and rather than defend the post, take the post away physically by moving the LSU players up the lane to get an extra out of their comfort zone. Here's Chris Walker, sophomore. Region of Knoxville after this. And 34-23, the Wildcats are still within reach in this game. Villanova with the basketball and 17-10 left to play. LSU 34, Villanova 23. The Wildcats have more turnovers than they have field goals, yet they're still within reach.
Well, there's just LSU has not really converted. They're in a two-two zone right now. The top of the key is wide open in the zone.
Presented by authority of the NCAA, and use of this program without written consent is prohibited. The authors for this program have been approved and contracted by NCAA production. Could be special adjustments by Gail Brown and Hall. For now, not seeing the ball particularly well. Roberts is 3-5. They go to the zone. They're going to tell Villanova, you've got to show us that you can hit it from out there. And they could tell him. He finds it out there. What is that? So does O'Neal, but O'Neal brings it in for LSU.
They're doing interesting things, slow down the LSU bridge. Every time the ball comes out, they're turning out towards Jackson so that when he touches it, he has to control it. He can't just walk the court with it. The leader looks to get the ball to Williamson, and he can take the ball up the floor.
Williamson got the ball and then sent it into O'Neal. And Woodard is called for the foul.
Defensive adjustment and slowing down the break, which hurt Villanova early and got him into a situation where they've had to play from behind. Jackson has to dial in. We'll just see how well they're able to run their offense.
And Bang in for it. Roberts catches the ball deep in the corner. Now waiting for the drive. Pass it around. Big play. The first 2-point field goal for Williamson, who has 14 points tonight.
Yeah, that's making something out of a mistake here. They couldn't get the ball, and they finally get to Roberts in the corner. Williamson steps in, catches the ball in the low post, which is the last place you expect him to be. Drives it to the basket and gets a possible 3-point play. Good job of making an adjustment to convert what looks like a bad situation into a very positive situation.
On the rebound of Williamson's miss, the foul was on Walker, who's second. Has yet to commit a foul in the second half.
They really extended their 2-3. They're trying to play the three perimeter guys with the two guards, which means the high post is wide open. Here it is.
There's a steal by Singleton. And he makes the sound down. The ball runs it down. And he'll bring it back out.
Great hustle by Chris Walker to come back. Bill Brown thinks this should have been a foul.
Williamson.
42-23. Right now it's a 36-23 lead. Well, that's you. Rollie said that's okay. That's the shot we want. I think they're getting the shot a little bit quick. But they want to keep warming inside. If that post in there, they can work inside out against the zone because the high post is wide open. Oh, man. That is a good. Woo! And the one is working for the foul. He has three fouls. Robert has three, so does Singleton. Well, it's just a guy. I mean, it's so physical right now. There's so much upper body. All those lines playing off each other with their upper body, and the official just in situation off the call. You're going to see it here on the right side. As the ball goes in, you can see O'Neal just pushes Taylor out of the way with his right arm and looks for the ball with his left hand.
Right in front of John Heimbach, who made the call.
What Villanova's not getting right now is any penetration with the ball. They're not drawing the defense to him. As a result, they're not getting an open shot on the perimeter. There, you got it inside. That's good.
Right, and O'Neal got a hand on
it. Robert throws it for LSU. Andy Duvall into the front court. O'Neal. O'Neal has control. He walks with the ball. Palmer call on O'Neal and LSU.
Well, the thing that I'm not really understanding right now is they elect every time to bring the ball into O'Neal's side, and O'Neal is the left of the power staff offensive play.
Bring it into Roberts and let Roberts work Bryce a little bit. Pick up a foul, get Bryce in trouble. What they've elected to do with O'Neal, and O'Neal just has not responded well offensively. And LSU is taking a shot out so far in the second half, 4-0. 36-23, our score. We get ready to run here to enter Robbie Taylor standing his job. He has a foul call there.
I'm chuckling, but boy, I mean to tell you, I don't know what everybody was looking at in here. It's just, it is absolutely bizarre the way guys are throwing arms and grabbing at arms and swinging and winging. And I find it hard to believe that there isn't something in there earlier, either a foul or a foul. But boy, they're letting them play, although it is getting, I think, a little bit too physical.
O'Neal picks up his fourth foul. And Wayne Sim will be coming in for LSU. Bryce can't get the roll. He's only made one free throw in four tries.
Well, this is a look to get the ball inside. The last two trips down, they've got it to Bryce. They've come up with pretty good opportunities. Bryce missed the shot. Now he's on the free throw line. But as they get the ball in there and he continues to look offensively to score, it's going to set up their perimeter game. And it's going to set it up in such a way that they're shooting those 12 and 14-foot jump shots instead of the 18 and 20-foot jump shot.
Bryce gets a breather. Bird is back in for Villanova.
Here we see the press again, which is what they had so much trouble with. Williamson handles the ball well.
Well, that play is made by Williamson simply stopping at the free throw line, making the defensive player commit. If he goes in too deep, then he's got nothing. Great judgment by Williamson. Robert finishes the play.
Williamson gets four assists per game for LSU and a bigger man. Here's Woody. Goddell around Robert. This is a shot for three that finally goes down. That's Miller has 15 now. 1-for-10 shooting in the second half for Villanova.
Let's put a job with him against the press this afternoon in the first half, LSU.
Villanova 1-for-10 from three-point range. Coming down to 15 minutes left in the game.
Robert on a great shot by the big guy. Boy, you talking about a pro move there. That's a defense by surprise.
40-27 LSU and Robert has six. This is Aaron Bowen.
Miller getting off the Goddell for the basket. Simply based on penetration. Two penetrating moves by two different players. Sees up Goddell going to the basket.
Goddell has four. Bird goes for the steal. Keeps the ball alive.
And gets the basket. Adam Bird throws his first goal.
Well, Williamson gets tails with the ball. He just nearly two casuals sometimes at the basketball. Six turnovers in the first half. Really no reason to turn the ball over against the press if you just use judgment.
Might have been an over and back.
LSU has turned the ball over seven times in the second half. Villanova has made two mistakes this half. Coming down to 12
for the play.
They've got it set up for Roberts. They're really going to go at Dowdell without Bryce in the game. And there's Bird, who scored the last basket. A 9-point lead for LSU. Here's Dowdell stepping up. And Roberts got in his way, and Clem scores it out. Williamson off to Singleton. He brings it back out. Here's Roberts. Williamson takes the three. And an offensive foul on Mo Williamson.
Good call. No question about it. Good call. Comes to a dead stop. Defensive man's in position is one thing to him. Once again, trying to do too much. This is where Williamson gets in trouble. He's there, jumps into him. No question on the call.
There's a timeout on the court with the score. LSU 40, Villanova 31. We'll be right back.
This makes trouble with the zone only because they've elected to play behind Bryce in the post. They can punch it into Bryce anytime they want. They also need to look to screen the backside and throw it over the top. They have elected just to pass the ball from one person to the next, and they're not making the zone work.
Singleton out of the point. Here's Roberts. Oh! 8 points for Stanley Roberts. We talked about him being the better of the two offensive players. The guy is a man child in there when he gets the basketball. Bryce is going to have to cinch up.
Now a 11-point lead for LSU. He averages 92 points a game this season. There's Miller. The ball goes over to LSU.
Well, here it is. He just does a good job with his big body of holding Bryce up. Great pass inside. You have to feed him on top. LSU elects. There you go, the turnover.
Dowdell to the middle. Here's Riddick.
Riddick tries to follow the shot that goes over to Chris Jackson. To follow up on that, LSU elects to have a double low post, which means, in fact, that as you try to pass the ball into the low post, there's always help. If you slice the guy into the high post from the backside, that clears help. Or if they make the feed come on top, then there is no help. So one of those two things needs to happen, and if those things happen, Roberts can get the ball in there all night long and take the ball to the basket.
And Dan comes in for Woodard. Bird replaces Bryce. Williamson has the ball for LSU. Every second he has, it's an adventure. An absolute adventure. You've got to play with your head up, pass the ball to open people, get the thing slowed down. He's just with his head down out of control. Williamson to Jackson for the jumper. Here's Bird for Villanova. Not just Walker. Walker's all for 8 shooting. Wow. Oh, what? Travel call. No basket for last night.
Good call. No question. 10:05 left to play. LSU 42, Villanova 31. Now, still the middle. LSU up and still the middle. Here's Roberts. He's really working with the ball.
Well, you know, they've identified him. This is the problem they've had all year long. They can't figure out where they want to go with the basketball. Many times, the place they need to go is the place they just came. They have to give the ball to him right now.
Here's Dowdell's shot. That's too high, and that's all because of what Roberts has been doing inside, what O'Neal was doing earlier. Roy's upset with Bryce and took him out, but he came out keep him out in this situation. They just don't have anybody to contend with Roberts, as big and strong as he is.
Jackson has 6 points. He hasn't scored in this half. He has the ball in the backcourt. So Roberts, he has 10 points. He's in the half.
Can't bring it down. He's to go with two hands. He's got that at half. Good identification by Chris Jackson. Walker on the outside. 9:16 left to play. Walker is yet to make a shot tonight for Villanova.
Once again, very little dribble penetration. They're not seeing the backside and throwing it over the top. And they've got the guy wide open in the post. Very much for three.
That's a 10-point game, LSU. Got to get the middle field against the press. Andrews is the volunteer for that. They seem to be content to get the ball across the same second line, and they don't stop the line.
They can't get the shot down. And the ball is committed inside. It's on to
ball across the 10-second line, and they were not finalizing.
Well, Brown's got a few Tigers, have a 44-34 lead over Willie Massimino's Villanova Wildcats with 8:40 left to play. In the second half, the first round Southeast Region game. They've got to finalize this success. They're bringing across the 10-second line. They're not getting anybody into the high post where they can deliver the ball to them and look on the basket. They have the ball on the side. That's the worst place to have it against the crowd.
Then from the corner, there's Robert. Robert takes it to the ball. He's holding it. And Rice is falling the hole.
No question. That's 2 fouls on Bryce. Gavin Berg waits to check in on the far sideline.
Really not happy with Bryce. They've elected to play in behind. They're going to give him the basketball, but all he has to play is position. You can see Roberts as he goes to move. Bryce just comes in with the elbows and the forearms and pushes him away from the ball. You have to call that. That affects play.
Williamson finds two times in Chris Jackson. A recent foul is called on Chris Walker. Next 3 fouls on Walker, 3 on Woodard. LSU's basketball from the sideline. All right, it's 1-1 time now. That's a foul that puts Villanova over the limit. LSU has committed only 3 fouls in the second half.
If Jackson has his score in the second half, we're looking at a guy that only got 6 shots in the first half, 6 points. And, you know, to think that LSU at this point could be up 10 with 8 minutes to go and him not really scoring, won't surprise anybody, but one thing you can bet on, he's not going to miss free throws. He's got 97% from the free throw line, and this is a guy that you cannot afford to foul, particularly late in the game.
He has hit 11 straight free throws. He had a 6-for-6 game against Auburn. 2-for-2 in this one. He's 3-for-7 from the field, 2-for-2 from the line, 8 points.
Well, Villanova has got to make a run. They've got to figure this zone out. They've got to start penetrating the gap. Cleaning the backside. As I mentioned before, they've got it open in the post. They just have to deliver the ball in the post, block the zone, and kick it out to Jeff Scott.
And that's a running ball. Bryce, with a step back. 10 half a time drive.
But that can't possibly be the shot that they want. They passed it 2 times and shot it on the post.
They're putting it all the way down. He's in the drive. It's a problem. You meet the most interesting people in the main venue.
Game's a game of judgment.
7:43 left in the game. LSU 46, Villanova 36. Huge. The Tigers have scored 46 tonight. Villanova's been averaging 71 points a game, but the Wildcats have the 36.
Well, we've talked at the top about keeping them under 1,700 chance to win, but we just didn't realize they were going to keep the ball for close.
Got to go in. It's got to go into the post. They've got to collapse the perimeter of people. They're getting away with guarding 3 perimeter players with 2 guards right there.
Right down the hole. Well, it's there. And you know, they've either got to identify it, LSU.
Going down the line of that play. Got Jackson. Villanova gets the ball. They're trying to cut it to a 6-point game.
LSU wants a timeout. They just have not handled. Right here, we've got the isolation. Bryce is on there, wide open. He turns and looks. Now, that brings people back to him. If nobody guards him, you turn four. If somebody comes back in, you kick it out and see the step-up jumper.
And Bryce has scored 12 points tonight. There's a timeout on the court with a score. That would be 46, and Villanova 38. Massimino, his team is trailing 46-38. But the Wildcats have the ball after a timeout. Chris Walker, who has had at least 1 3-point field goal in the last 11 games, is over 7 in 3-point range tonight. Well, he has made plenty of mistakes. Let's see if Villanova can cut the gap. That's a shot for 3. No good for Walker. Now he's 0-for-8 from 3-point range.
Well, when you're 2-for-14 from 3-point and 27% from the field, I mean, you know, you got to feel pretty good. You're only down 8.
And Sanderson going in, and a block is shot against Wright. 3 fouls on Tom Brown.
Once again, ball in the low post creates so much activity around the basketball, it just opens things up. You have to catch the ball in the low post and look opposite. All the help coming from the backside, and now you've got Bryce in there with all of a sudden 4 fouls, and he's the only guy in there that can compete with the big guys for LSU.
Well, so here is 4 fouls for Bryce. Anderson has another shot coming.
Pendleton is 1 of 6 from the field. And he's 60% free throw shooting. Here are 3 points. Villanova's got to make a run. They've got to be somewhere in a reasonable margin inside that 3 minute mark. They've got to make a run. They can't not stay back. And then walk around the outside. Taylor comes out to get the ball. Taylor's in trouble. He finds it out to Walker. Miller steps inside Riley, finding Bryce. There's Walker for three. That's a big basket. It's a big basket for a lot of reasons. It gets him back into a reasonable range, but also Walker's got to feel better. That's his first basket tonight. Good offense against the press. And now Singleton has five. Woody threw the ball away, and Jackson will inbound now for LSU. Get the ball in the middle, your LSU. That's O'Neal. He gets his own rebound. Oh, good basket. Roy's got to take a look at a timeout. I think they just got to talk about, hey, are we going to be around this tournament? We're down to 6 minutes, and we've got to have make something happen. O'Neal with 9 points now for LSU, and the Tigers back to his own. Roberts couldn't hit his second 3-point shot. Roberts rebound. Ooh, Williams handling the ball. A little travel there. It's probably Jackson really taking the ball, taking the game under more control. He seems to be content to play off of Williamson as a point player. Now Roberts is right. 12 for Roberts. He's looking timeout. He's got to get this shot. No, he decided not to. Walker pulled up and said he was ready to call a timeout. Now here comes Jackson. He should have, because he's going to have to get one now. Jackson has 10. He's getting away. 55-41 LSU. LSU had a 17-point lead in the first half. What is from the 3-point line? Good penetration, good jump off. And he's got the three. People as it can be. Their offense is based around penetrating, bringing people to you, and then sticking it out. It's an 11-point game now. Pendleton pulls up and drives it out to Jackson. Over Roberts. Back to Jackson. The foul off Villanova. Execution. Mike Gondell is back in along with Aaron Bain. Taylor goes out, and so does Greg Woody. Jackson will inbound the ball now for LSU. The 4:20 left to play. And the Bayou Bengals leading 55-44. The ball. And Williamson saves it out front.
Well, when you kept it alive, you know, you don't always have to rebound the ball by touching it. You can also keep it alive, which you did by tipping it.
They're sending in low. They've got to flash the opposite guy and look for the lob. Williamson protects the ball. Boom, he's over on Williamson now. LSU has too much trouble with very, I think, position-like pressure because they don't look into the high post. They have the two guys in the low post, and when they sense pressure, those big guys have got to flash and help release pressure. Otherwise, you know, you can have one guy down there guarding both of them.
Now with the shot clock inside 10, Williamson drives inside for Robert. Rebound by Dowell with Villanova. There's Walker in the front court now for the Wildcats. A long rebound, Banton, and got it to go Williamson, stuck in front. Williamson to Pendleton, 57-44 LSU.
Williamson sometimes makes such a good decision, but so many times makes such a bad decision.
Down ball, in the lane. Got it by Shaquille O'Neal.
They pump. No, for three. Right here. Here's Jackson. Yes. Get a
6 points.
Well, the fact here, as much problems as LSU has had in getting the ball in bounds, they need to think seriously about bringing one of the big guys up and just lobbing the ball. Jackson takes it out, lobbies, kick it back to him clear, but you can't run down the floor like three guys in the backcourt, particularly against the zone press, not fill the middle and expect not to have problems. The big guys can't disappear down the floor. They've got to provide some kind of relief, and there needs to be somebody in the middle, especially against the 1-2-1-1. Well, we're just talking athletic ability. Once again, Williamson makes the right decision. You know, you're talking about a guy that you can get because he's standing next to the two, you know, monsters. He's 6'7". He plays with his elbow above the rim, but his last size is relative. And when you look at him out there, you say, hey, that guy's 6'3". But he's standing next to two guys that are 7'7", about 280. The kids from Clemson and the great win and against the course of Pumbo and also morning the short count. But you know, if you can't appreciate how big these guys and how physical they are until they lean on you all night long, and it just simply comes down to when you don't shoot the ball well, you don't look like you're playing well. Villanova has done some things very nicely tonight. They just haven't got it in the basket.
LSU is 18-0 and shooting 50% or better tonight. The Tigers are 49% from the field.
Here's to bring O'Neal up and just lob the ball to him.
He's got a lob it though. And he's taking away from John Wall. And behind Singleton, out of bounds to Villanova.
Well, everybody gets in a hurry. I mean, there's no reason for him to get in a hurry. You know, O'Neal gets fouled. There's no call, but realistically, Singleton's a lot like the floor out of control. There's really no reason to be in a hurry. And if he's going to lob the ball, lob the ball.
And he's right back in for Villanova.
Oh, goody lock. Here we go.
Jackson and Singleton combined with Jackson. Is
that an unbelievable shot?
Chris Jackson has got his 13 to 14 points of the game. He's in LSU, a 51-47 lead. And now a foul call on the ace, waiting for his third for LSU.
And that's exactly what you got. He's 12 to go up 14 is to put him on the free throw line. There you see the block. Outstanding play by Jackson. It looks like Miller's going to get the block. In fact, Steve has it. Jackson pumps, pulls it down, brings it back up. Still gets the basket with Williamson on the follow if he would have missed. Rapid. He's trying to be free.
Just now for Matt Jardin. And a timeout for Villanova with 2:04 left in the game. 61-40.
Villanova's a game bunch. You know, just when you think that the LSU has applied the knockout, they're hanging around. Now, 12 points is a lot of points in 2:04. But LSU has had so much trouble with the press. I'm a little surprised they've elected to have Williamson handling the ball, as opposed to allowing Chris Jackson to handle the ball. They need to get the middle field. They need to use the big guys as a relief. And then they need to run the clock.
Well, in Aquino, Jeff used up his last
all that, and that simply is if you have the ball in Chris Jackson's hands, he's shooting 91%. So the team statistic's a little bit misleading because if Jackson will not take control and handle the basketball, they're going to have the guy on the free throw line that is not going to miss many free throws down the stretch. So this is a tough situation because they'll know that they still not allow Chris Jackson to handle the basketball.
Basketball committee representative Roy Kern, who is a halftime guest tonight. Tournament manager Gus Manning, tournament media coordinator Haywood Harris, Villanova, the athletic director Ted Osetto, the basketball coach Willie Massimino, the sports information director Craig Miller, that's Meadows here, athletic director Joe Dean, the basketball coach Bill Brown, and basketball sports information director Kent Lowe.
So you can run the baseline now. You don't have to get stuck. You've got to bust it now. You've got to pull it off. Oh, he's going to foul.
Williamson's hitting the ball out of bounds. No foul call, though. I'm just
right. backside, shoot some step-up jump shots. They can't be dribbling it, trying to take it to the basket with 1:48 to go down 12. They've got to make something happen, and it's got to be positive from three-point range. Team down, easy shot. Out of bounds to Villanova. Woodard, who just cleared Ryan Walker to go to the baseline. Woodard has scored in double figures in 22 of 32 games this year. Tonight, only 3 points, and he's won it by from the field.
Yeah, and he's a much better shooter than that, but that's part of the intimidation factor.
This is Walker. Oh, look, he doesn't have any technical foul. We don't have any timeouts. Villanova calls a timeout. There are no timeouts left. We don't have a technical foul. Bryce calls a timeout.
Yes. Now that if you have the timeout, you have the free throws as well as now possession. So we're looking at a possible 6 point swing. Two on the free throws.
Two for two from the free throw line tonight. Jackson has hit 13 straight free throws. A one check, and he hit 35 in a row.
Tell you what, though, them getting the ball inbounds is at very best an adventure. So, I mean, you know, this is not one of those deals where, you know, this may be a good move by Villanova, aside from the fact, though, that Chris Jackson has made the free throws, because LSU's no shit but to get this thing inbounds.
63-52, LSU. And with a two free throws, Chris Jackson is 16 points, keeping 92 in, averaging 28.7.
Well, if you're Villanova, what you have to try to do now is get your press set up in such a way that you allow, you either deny completely, or you allow a player who you want to foul to get the ball in bounds. You know, to let Chris Jackson handle the basketball, you can't afford to give up the time. So if you can foul, as soon as the ball comes in, foul him, then that gives you an opportunity to get a certain player to the free throw line. But to try to deny anybody comes in, to try to shut down Chris Jackson after he gets the ball, that's a no-win situation. Too clever with the basketball, and he shoots free throws too well.
The three-point range is over 37%. Two free throws, the two technical shots were made by Chris Jackson. And Jackson will inbound the ball in front of it.
That's a lob again if you need it. Just get it up.
There's a lob to Singleton.
Oh my God, I thought he was going to run back.
Stood down for a moment and walked with the ball.
I honestly, you know, I thought he was shooting.
Bryce and Bain come back in now for Villanova. Bird and Taylor come out.
Well, as I mentioned to you, it's an adventure. It's an adventure every time they take the ball in down. And it shouldn't be. Oh, yes.
Here's Bain high off the glass. That is three back for LSU. All of his back much better.
Good quick foul.
128 left with LSU at 63-52.
Well, Roberts has played awfully well for him tonight, particularly in the second half, and he's played extremely well when O'Neal's been out of the game. But, you know, these two big guys are so physical and so strong, and they pound on you all night long that eventually it takes its toll.
It's funny how a few games at the end of the season and some tough losses that LSU expected to win. That can put the Tigers on a season where we have 22 victories for the Tigers.
Well, they're so young, and their expectations are so unrealistic. You don't win the freshman and sophomores on a regular basis the way people expected these guys to win. Boy, they're holding them.
Chris Jackson has 12 points all on three. Williamson will shoot a 1-1. After the Villanova bit of both. It's been an unrealistic expectation, and yet they have not played to the level that they're capable of. And part of that is just that they have not really had continuity in what they're doing. One half it's the Chris Jackson show, the next half it's the Robert O'Neill show, and they haven't had a very good blend. Plus, this is the best they've played defensively all year long.
Well, Williamson, who will be at the free throw line after the LSU timeout, scored 14 points tonight, 4 3-point shots, and a 2-point field goal. He'll be at the line, he's 0-1 from the free throw line. There's points tonight, 14 and 13 turnovers.
Well, you know, not to beat a dead horse, but because it's a day old now, but the news out of Baton Rouge is that Chris Jackson has either already told his teammates or has made the decision to go tight-ship to the NBA. This is just another game for him to have an opportunity to play, and it'll be interesting to see that story unfold. But I think LSU has shown, regardless of the situation, they're a team to be reckoned with, at least in this tournament. Now, they can't be worried about what's going to happen next week or next year. They've got to be concerned about what's happening in the last 10 and 15 now and what's going to happen on Saturday, because they're looking at strapping on somebody pretty good, as you do when you get through those first round games.
Well, Dale Brown, he always gives us good copies, and some good lines for you. Here's Arkansas leading Clemson by three at halftime in the Midwest. But it's great to Dale Brown. He'll always give us some good copies. And he was taking all the heat yesterday because of the way energy was going down the stretch. He said, look, I have no more captain. I'm the captain. I'm the coach. I'm the assistant coach in the center. Roll it all in the water.
He said he was going to come out before the game. He didn't hit, and he really tried to. He tried to, and he said, no, you have to have a captain on the floor. So then he appointed O'Neill, but you have to get a kick out of it, because a week ago he told people he wasn't going to talk anything about basketball, and then yesterday, of course, he was back talking about Venus and scouting and all those different things. But God love him, he plays for basketball. He's powerful, and there's no question that he has his team ready to play tonight.
Williamson is over there from the free throw line.
It's unbelievable watching what's going on here. I mean, we're sitting here talking about this and that later, and all of a sudden it's a five-point game in a minute. The guy is a master in the last minute and a half of the game, and that's why he's never lost a first round game in the NCAA tournament. Well, they just double screen for Walker, and Walker all of a sudden has found it, keeps it over Roberts, nothing but the bottom of the net.
Williamson back to the line. They shoot a 1-1. He missed the front end a moment ago. The foul is on Lance Miller, sending Williamson to the line.
Well, you have to remember, in the game against Georgia, a really critical game earlier in the year where they had Georgia put away, they missed the front end of 10-1-1, and Georgia beat them at the buzzer. They're going to have to make free throws, but I still think they have to get the ball to Chris Jackson's hand.
Williamson makes it a 65-58 LSU lead.
Making them work the ball up, takes time off. Good move by Dale.
Miller steps up looking for Walker. Walker throws up a three.
Well, it's not here to chase it down. It's out of bounds, though.
All that LSU is some good hustle over on the sideline by Vernell Singleton.
Well, Walker, instead of shooting a fadeaway three-pointer, needs to go straight up because Williamson is all over and he's going to get to the free throw line. LSU's got to be careful. They're playing the clock now. They've got to make sure that they're not giving up a potential four-point play by fouling on a fadeaway jump shot at three-point range. There's Robinson.
And there's a foul on Williamson.
I don't understand it. Well, I'm okay. It's Dale Brown hot. I mean, Maurice Williamson right now does not want to go to the bench.
Chris Walker does want the free throw line.
Well, I mean, this just makes no sense. You're playing the clock. And there's no question, if the thing goes in, you're looking at a possible four-point play. And you've only got a seven-point lead. Your enemy right now is the clock and making free throws. You've got enough points to win the game if you take care of the ball. And if you shoot free throws, you're assured of having enough points. Villanova can't get enough possessions unless you allow them to score with the clock stop.
Walker scored 1 point with the clock stop at 44 seconds. 2 points. 17 for Chris Walker. And LSU takes the timeout with 44 seconds left. And it's a 5-point game. LSU is 65. And Villanova 60.
This is so typical of LSU. It just slides and slides and slides. And all of a sudden, you look up and you get the game Jackson, get him on the free throw line, and at the other end, contest shot. There's no more timeouts. Villanova can't get the clock stop, so don't stop the clock for him. Villanova tried to call a timeout while the girl got hit with a technical. You allow the other team to cut down the distance, they have to travel if a mistake is made. So what you want to do is try to get the ball going toward your basket. Then if there's an interception, you pick up, you force them to work the ball up the floor, take time off the clock. Like I say, possession and time is in your favor. Today, in the first round, Michigan State won over Murray State 75-71 in overtime. UC Santa Barbara defeated Houston 70-66. So it's Houston Santa Barbara against Michigan State at 4:50 Eastern Time on Saturday. We have 44 seconds remaining in this first round Southeast Region game. LSU with a 5-point lead over Villanova. And Villanova still hanging on with 44 seconds left. This clock has come alive for them. They've got to get the ball. They've got to get the ball now. To Chris Jackson. They're not looking to get the ball quickly enough for the 91% free throw shooter.
Shaquille O'Neal, the 18-year-old freshman from San Antonio, Texas, is a 54% free throw shooter. He's 1-for-3 tonight. Goddard committed the foul.
The other thing that's a little bit interesting is that they elect to come out of their zone press offense, or their press offense, without really screening. Each guy is working on his own. And, they need to think about screening for Jackson and bringing him off into an open area rather than trying to get him open on his own, because Villanova can double up on him and see if he can get him open.
Yeah, those
good free throws. Now, LSU's making Villanova work the ball up the floor. They just can't stop.
Chris Walker.
You've got two teams playing here with only really one team. You've got to give both teams a lot of credit.
Gardell reaches over. Four fouls on Mark Gardell.
And Riley's saying, I can't believe it. And I tell you, he really had the case, because it looks like O'Neal may have pushed off here. Here we see the lob. Once again, it's not necessary. But that's LSU. That's the way they play. That's where they're comfortable. They have to play the way they feel that best suited to play. You know, where a lot of coaches would say, back it out, use the clock. In their opinion, that's a sure thing.
One and one now for Shaquille O'Neal. 11 points, 11 rebounds, 3 blocks. 12 points now for O'Neal.
As I said earlier, if you're a big guy and you can make free throws, you're going to be in double figures every night out.
A 10-point game. It stays that way. Rice with the rebound.
Good pickup. Once again, using the clock. Don't foul.
That's a three.
Well, in this timeout, they really don't have to get the ball in bounds.
That's a foul on Bam. 3 seconds to go. 73 LSU.
Who would have thought Villanova would have shot the ball so poorly? They were so loose, so confident, so ready to play. And they just could not get it to go down early. They started to press on their shot. LSU created problems because of their domination inside and intimidation. Villanova could just never get it to a workable number.
Williams and on the miss. And that's the game. LSU advances to the line. East Tennessee State and Georgia Tech are coming up. 70, Villanova 60. Mm-hmm.